Hi, this is Bram Roden. Welcome to Tiger News Network.
And I'm Bree Minetti. Welcome to this year's second edition of the show.
I wish I was a slave to an age-old trade, like riding around on rail cars and working long days. Lord, have mercy on my rough and rowdy ways. Lord, have mercy on my rough and rowdy ways.
As summer turns to fall, fashion takes the focus for many students.
Bree, Brooke, and Caitlin have the story.
As summer comes to an end and fall approaches, we say goodbye to the Daisy Duke shorts and flip-flops. And hello to the scarves and hats.
My name is Christy Krauss, and I'm a senior this year.
I'm sorry, Mother. I'm sorry I let you down. Well, these days I'm fine. No,
I must say my obsession right now is one-of-a-kind, unique things that people will kind of wonder about, I guess. One of my favorite shirts I have is actually, it's a vintage tank top that says, Yo heart el medio ambiente, which means I love the environment in Spanish, and so people will ask me what it means, and I'm like, oh, I love the environment, and it's fun, so that's one of my favorite pieces that I have, and yeah. A lot of my inspiration is from my surroundings and nature, and so the different seasons, you know, it changes. Summer, I love wearing super bright things. Here in fall, I'm kind of going to be obsessed with prints and patterns that pertain to fall.
Hi, I'm Tay Michi and I'm a junior this year. Where do I like to shop? I like to say anywhere cheap because I'm a big bargain kind of person. My personal style is something that I don't see most people wear. It's like a twist to what normal people wear, so that way I stand out, and most people are like, oh, wow, she looks cute, and I'm like, no. I'm just kidding. I just like something that makes me stand out. This fall, I think I'm looking forward to wearing lots of sweaters and socks with boots and cute skirts to go with all of it, and just warm clothing. Well, I'm absolutely and positively obsessed with shoes. Like to buy one, wear a week, and then buy another pair, and then go back and be like, oh, I forgot I had these, and it's like finding a gift or a dollar in my pocket that I didn't know of.
What are some trends I'm seeing this fall? I think colors are still gonna work, guy and girl. I think that plaids, you can totally wear plaid on plaid or pattern on pattern. I know it sounds weird, but you can do it. You just have to know how to rock it. There's teenage boy, then there's teenage girl, there's supermodels, and then I'm somewhere above that. It takes me quite a while to get ready. It's embarrassing, actually. My bed is strung out with clothes everywhere every morning because I have to find what I need to wear. I can't get enough of sweaters. I'm a girl about those things.
So, high school students, happy fall fashioning. It's hard. Check out how Catherine Ambrose lives in the heart of the UCM campus.
Many UCM students and Warrensburg residents pass by Selma Park, the UCM Presidential Manor, without a second glance. TNN visited with a WHS student and resident of Selma Park who discusses her experience living in the manor.
Not just friendship, that's romance too. You like music, we can dance.
My name is Catherine Ambrose. I've lived in this house for 2 years. This house is named Selma Park. 8 Central Missouri presidents have lived here. It was built in 1866 as a mansion for the president of the college, and it's also a reception center. I moved to this house because my dad got a new job, and the house kind of came with the job. Favorite part about living in this house is probably the convenience of it being in the middle of like town and not being too far away from anything. Like, school's only about 5 minutes away, and I can go get Chick-fil-A whenever I want, and it's just all reasonable. My least favorite part is probably how it's in the middle of campus and students just walk up whenever they want and come in, and like at night when they're drunk, they'll come up and leave their phones on my porch, and then we have to find out whose phone it is. My parents like this house because it's roomy and there's enough space to put all of our stuff, and it has a garage, which is good for all of our like bikes and outdoor stuff because we're like an outdoorsy family. When I first heard about this house, I heard that it was like on 100 acres of land, and my dad said we could get like 4-wheelers and stuff. Then I got here and realized that it definitely wasn't on 100 acres of land, and I could see dorms all around. When we moved in, I got paint my room, and it felt kind of homey. This house, not just my home, it's my life.
Find out the dangers of texting and driving with videographer Sam Caballero.
Dear Mom, Dad, family, loved ones, I'm sorry I did it. I can make excuses like everyone does it, but that would be wrong of me. I know you'll miss me very much. I never meant to hurt you all. In all honesty, I regret the mistake I've made. If I have any advice to share with whoever is reading this, it is to not make the same mistake, to learn from my error. Goodbye, Mother. Goodbye, Father. Goodbye, world. Goodbye forever. T.J. Clausen's story reveals the many truths about twin lifestyles.
A lot of people are under the assumption that since we're twins, we share everything.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, rooms.
I get the question. Do you guys share the room? No.
Do you guys have bunk beds? That'd be awesome. That's... You guys are twins.
How fickle my heart and how woozy my eyes. I struggle to find any truth in your lies. And now my heart stumbles on things I don't know. My weakness I feel I must finally show.
We were born March 2nd, 1996, and I was born at 10:20 p.m., and he was born at 10:40 p.m., so big gap.
Could have been another day difference. My mom said she wanted to have me the next day, but I don't think they'd let her.
We're both 17 and we're 5 minutes apart, 10:30 to 10:35.
She was born first by 15 minutes and I came after. I kicked her out.
I'm 14 and I was born February 1st, 1998.
I'm older by 25 minutes.
June 8th, 1998, and we're 8 minutes apart.
We were born on August 2nd, 1996, and I am a minute older than him.
We're both 15, but we don't know which one's older.
Our parents said they'll put it in the will.
They're never gonna tell us because...
We get to, like, do stuff together. Like, you're never alone, I guess.
And, like, if you're going into a new situation, like, when we moved here, going to a new school, it was easier because we already knew someone.
I have to share everything.
Yeah, we shared rooms and clothes and stuff. And eventually, we also shared haircuts. Every time he got a haircut, I had to, so.
Yeah.
We always looked the same.
Growing up, I never really had to do anything alone because he was there with me. So, like, walking into the first day of school, I wasn't scared because I had him with me. And
growing up, I just always had someone there. He wasn't really ever far away. It was just, like, a little bit of play buddy.
Growing up, I could, like, always copy homework. And
our freshman year, I'd always beat him in races. Every single race except one, I beat him in cross country. So we just said I was better at distance and he's better at sprinting.
I've never ran the mile, and so he automatically says, oh, I'm better at the mile, Alex. It's yet to be determined.
Patience didn't play any sports at all. Dancing is a sport, Riley. It's not an official sport.
Well, it's physical activity. It's close enough. I like do dancing and singing more, and she does all the sports.
Yeah, I play volleyball, basketball, and soccer.
Mm-hmm.
I tell people that I'm nicer and I'm more fun to be around than she is. But, our faces are shaped differently. Mine's like more like a pear, hers is more like an apple. And I have a mole right here and she has one right here.
Hey, we don't really know. Some people say our faces.
And one of my friends have a joke that say if I was a girl, I would be the prettier one. So.
Yeah, because of his eyelashes apparently.
We look at each other and we just like, he's uglier.
We joke around about that.
So, yeah.
I'll usually say something funny or just mean about Alex. And they're like, I'll tell him he's a bigger nose and I'm the nicer twin. And they're just like, oh, okay, I agree with that. Or, but like, he does have a bigger nose.
And our noses are the same size, if anyone asks.
How often do you guys get mistaken for each other?
All the time.
Our parents can't tell us apart. My aunt's like, you, boy, come here.
Our cousins, who are 4 and 2, tell us apart better than anyone else.
Yeah.
During races, a lot of times it's like, oh, Max is probably in front. And so...
Most of the time.
No, depends on the race. And so I'll hear, go Bursons, that's the usual one. Then I'll hear, go Max. Last race, I don't think I heard, go Alex.
And at home, sometimes we even get called the wrong name.
I have been mistaken for Matthew once. I don't know why, and I don't know how. They just called me Matthew instead of Rebecca, and that was very awkward.
I've never been mistaken once. I've been mistaken for other people, but not twin.
Especially when we were younger, I'd wear blue, and he'd wear red. It's kind of separating us then. To me, to be called Max is just like, I don't know you well enough to call you Alex, so I'm just gonna guess.
Or the, I don't care, you're...
The same person.
Mm-hmm. It's really annoying, but...
My favorite one is when, in fifth grade, we swapped jackets to screw around with people, and our teacher almost gave us 2 detentions,
because... Because we didn't even switch classes, and...
I went back in the class, and she remembered that I was wearing a different jacket, and she told me to get out. I was like, but I'm in this class, and she almost gave me a detention.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did in fifth grade. We switched classes for April Fool's Day.
Well, yeah, kind of, and I got caught, so.
So my freshman year, I was sick a lot, so I'm like, hey, Aaron, can you fill in for me? And I just give him my clothes, and he'll go run what I run, and.
Sometimes I'll tell people I have twin telepathy. You're like, what, really? That's awesome. Like, it doesn't work when it's sunny, cloudy, rainy, stormy, day, night, or if the temperature's between negative 50 to 150 Fahrenheit, they're like, so it never works, yeah.
I can really feel whenever she's maybe not happy or what she's thinking, or maybe she's telling a lie there, maybe my parents.
When we were little, we used our hands to talk, which I still do it now. I generally talk with my hands, and that's all we did. We used our hands to talk. We would point and stuff, and we'd understand each other. So
yeah, we wouldn't talk to anyone but ourselves and use sign language and stuff. So
my arm was hurting in volleyball practice.
Yeah, and then I got in the car after cross country practice. I was like, man, my shoulder really hurts today. She's like, what? Really? Which shoulder? My right shoulder. She's like, whoa. Me too.
That's the only time it's ever happened.
Pretty much.
Just having him there to push me in cross country and track. I mean, if I didn't have Alex, I don't know if I'd be nearly as good as I was now. Like, at all. So I'm glad I have him in that.
Thanks for watching this year's second edition of the show. I'm Bree Minetti.
And I'm Brom Roden, signing out with TNN.
Walking away like we always do, because we're walk-awayers.
I took a walk.